Hello, my dear students. All right, we'll be starting today with your chapter number 7, that is Animals, Habitat and Adaptation. Last week we have done with chapter 6, that was your Soil Erosion and Conservation. Today we'll start with a fresh new chapter, that is Animals, Habitat and Adaptation. Now, what do you mean by the term habitat? What is habitat? Habitat is a natural home or a place for a plant or animal, okay, for their survival. They survive there, they stay there, live there, okay. So that's the natural home or environment of a plant or other organisms, animals also. And what do you mean by the term adaptation? It's a process or action of adapting or being adapted. Adapted is to adjust to the condition, okay. So what do you mean by adaptation? It's actually a special feature that allows a plant or animal to live in a particular place or habitat. And these adaptations might make it very difficult for animals to survive in different places. So, it explains why certain animals are found in one area but not in another. Okay, so actually, in short, if you say adaptation is trying to adjust to the surrounding environment using its special feature, and habitat is the place where it lives. Okay, before we start the lesson, I need you to solve this crossword puzzle. Okay, you'll have to I would like to advise you first write the answers here, then it will be easy for you to solve this puzzle. I will give the answers for you, I'll discuss the answers for you. The puzzles you'll have to find it out. An animal that has a thick furry coat. Okay, so animal which has a thick furry coat. So obviously it will be the animal who lives in a very cold region, and to keep itself warm, they have a thick furry coat in their over them, means above the skin. Okay, so that animal is polar bear. Next, an animal that crawls on the ground. Okay, which animal don't have feet and crawl on the ground? That is snake. An animal that lives both on land and in water. That is an amphibian. Which animal lives both on land and water? A common amphibian we all know is frog. Okay, an animal that has 6 legs. So it comes under insects. And that will be cockroach. You can find it out here in this crossword puzzle. And the largest living mammal is whale. Okay, the largest living mammal is whale. Alright, now habitats and adaptation. Already I have told you what is habitat and adaptation for the animals. Now let's go through the lesson. The earth has different types of climate at different places. So, climates are not similar in all the places. They differ in according to different places. In hot parts of the world, there are dry and sandy desert as well as damp forests. Okay, that is one part of the earth or a place with one type of climate. Okay, next, in cooler areas, there are different kinds of forests as well as grassland. The polar regions are extremely cold. Okay, the polar region, they are extremely cold. Areas near the seas may be warm and humid, while other places may be very cool and dry. Now you see the different, like we have seen, no, like different areas have different climates. So let's see the different areas, that is dry and sandy desert, damp forest, then you can say grassland, polar regions, seas. So these are the different areas where different animals can be found. Now animals are found in all these areas, and the places where they live naturally are called their habitat, that is their home. The place where they live is known as their habitat. In each habitat, the temperature and humidity are different. The food available in each habitat also are different. So the temperature is different in each of the habitats, and the food which they get is very different for each animal. So the animals in each habitat develop special features to adjust or adapt to these conditions. Okay, so since they live in different habitats, they have certain special features which help them to adjust in that environment or in that place or the condition. The ways in which animals adjust so that they can live in that habitat is called adaptation. So what do you mean by the word adaptation? By using the special features, they can adjust and live in that area or in their habitat. That is known as adaptation. There are many kinds of forests in the world. Okay, we don't have only one or two types, but we have many kinds of forests in the world. And forest, what it provides? It provides habitat to different kinds of animals. That means it provides a place for different kinds of animals for their survival. These animals to adapt to the conditions prevailing in the forest. So the animals, they have different features which help them to survive in that condition. Now in hot and wet areas around the world, there are jungles and forests. In India, where are they found? They are found in the mountains of Western Ghats. Most animals live on trees. So we'll see few animals, they live on trees. And where they can find the food? They find the food on the trees. Alright. The trees, what they provide? It provides leaves, fruits, nuts. Okay, for which types of animals? Bats, monkeys, and even different kinds of birds. Okay, so trees, habitat, trees, the habitat means a place where like bats, monkeys, and birds, they live. Okay, they live on the nest. They make the nest like birds live, makes the nest on the trees. They eat the fruits. They eat nuts. Okay, next we'll see is forest floor, and it's covered with what? It's covered with dead leaves and plants. Okay, the forest floors, they are covered with dead leaves and plants. And when these dead leaves and plants, they decay, they provide food for the insects. Now frogs and lizards, they live on the insects. Okay, so these insects, they live on the forest floor, and now for food, frogs and lizards, they depend on the insect. And there are bees, butterflies, moths, mosquitoes, and spiders also, which live on the forest floor. Snakes and larger birds prey on the smaller animals. Now you see the small bees, butterflies, moths, they also are small insects who are found who live on the forest floor. Now snakes also live there, and even larger birds, and they depend for food. For their food, they depend on the small animals. On the ground, there may be other types also, like porcupines, deer, and many kinds of rodents. Okay, so these are the different types of animals which are found on the forest. Next, animals living in the desert. Okay, so we have seen animals which live in the forest. Now we'll see animals which live in the desert. Desert are places where there occurs very little or no rainfall, means very less amount of rainfall occurs in the areas such as desert. Most of deserts are sandy and rocky places. Okay. Now it's very hot in daytime and quite cool at nighttime. In desert, what it happen? It's very hot during the daytime and it's quite cool during the nighttime. Animals that live in the deserts learn how to live with less water. So they have certain adaptation which helps them to survive in the desert areas. They have to use what is available very carefully. Such adaptation they have that they adjust and try to survive in desert area with less amount of water. Many of the animals like snakes, they come out only at night when it is cool. During the day hot day, they stay in their cool underground home. So what the snake does, it does not come out during the daytime since it is very hot. So what they do, they come out only during the night time. Okay. That's one type of animal found in the desert. Next, camels. Camels, how they stay? They can stay without water for a longer period of time. Okay, why? How they can stay for a longer period of time? Because it stores fats in its hump. And when it does not get food for a long time, it uses this fat. Okay, that's how it's able to survive without food for a longer period of time. It stores water for a long time. And then it even uses stored fat in its hump when it does not get food. And it has broad feet with thick pads. With the help of this, they are able to walk on the desert. They spread out as it walks so that its feet do not sink in the sand. That means it do not go deep into the sand. That's how its feet is. They have adaptation. Okay, the features in their feet. Okay, it's a special feature. The feet They have long legs and large padded soles, which helps them to survive and walk on the desert. And they have long eyelashes. So, because you know in desert what happens, the wind blows, sand flies. Okay, so this long eyelashes, it protects the camel from those sands to enter the eyes. That's how it's able to adapt in the desert. Now, animals that live in cold region. Okay. The ground is frozen for most of the time near the north and the south pole. So, you know the north pole and south pole is very frozen. With ice and very cold in such areas. It is covered with ice and snow throughout the year. In cold regions, animals which live on land are like polar bears, the Arctic fox, caribou, and reindeer. Okay, these are the animals which are found on the land. That is in the polar regions, the land area, these animals are found. And again in the water area, walrus, seals, and many kinds of whales. Okay, in polar regions, in the water areas, these walrus, seals, and kinds of whales are found. And again in the air, what are found? Several kinds of birds, bees, wasps, butterflies, moths, grasshoppers, beetles, these are found. Alright, so in polar regions, you have different areas like land, water, and air also. Like other regions also. So, the different animals that they are found on the land, water, and air. Polar bear, how it's adapted to live there, we'll see. It's adapted to live near the extremely cold North Pole. How it's able to survive there? Because of the thick furry coat which keeps it warm. Okay, they have a thick furry coat which keeps the polar bear's body warm. And how it survives, what it eats? It eats fish, seals, okay, which are found in the water areas. And even it's a good swimmer. Thus, it can catch its food also. Alright, for its survival. Next, the water of Arctic Ocean near the North Pole is freezingly cold. Okay, and what are found there? Seals, which live in the water, have to keep warm. Okay, how they are able to keep themselves warm? Because of a thick layer of blubber or fat under their skin. That's how seals keep their body warm. And this blubber or fat, it's a good insulator and it helps to maintain the heat of the body in case of seals. Penguin, it's an unusual bird which lives in Antarctic near the South Pole. Penguins cannot fly. Instead, they have wings. Okay, the wings, it has short, strong flippers. And nearly 1 meter tall, it waddles about clumsily when it is on land. Waddles is what? Walk in short steps. They cannot take large steps to walk. They take short steps when they walk. And how it survives, what it eats? It eats fish and it can swim easily in cold water to catch them. So it survives on fish by living there. So we have completed with those terrestrial animals. Okay, now we will see aquatic animals. Alright, habitat. Based on habitat, these animals are divided into two groups actually. They are the terrestrial animals and these aquatic animals. Okay, now we will see about the aquatic animals. Fish of many kinds, they live where? In which areas do they live? They live in ponds, rivers, seas. Okay, and those that live on the sea, they are called saltwater fish. And those which live on lakes and ponds, they are called freshwater fish. You should know the difference. Fish, how they are adapted to live in water? They use their fins, tails to swim. Okay, and the water, it flows through their gills. Now what happens? When this water, it flows through their gills, the fish, they absorb what? They absorb oxygen, okay, which is dissolved in water. That's how they are able to breathe. Fish lay eggs in the water. Next, we'll see whales and dolphins. Whales and dolphins are aquatic animals, but they are not fish. Since they are not fish, they come under the group of mammals. Alright, and how they are surviving? They have lungs to breathe. Okay, through lungs they breathe. And they get the air, breathe in air to get the oxygen. So the breathing organ is lungs. This means that they have to come up to the surface of water to breathe. Okay, they don't for getting the air or the oxygen to breathe. What they do? They come to the surface of the water, they get the air, and again they go into the water. That's how they are able to breathe. They do not lay eggs. Since they are mammals, they do not lay eggs. Instead, they give birth to babies. Birds. Birds like heron and stork, they live near water. And how they are able to survive? What are the adaptations? Their long, thin legs help them to wade. What is the meaning of wade? That is, walk with effort through the water, right? Pushing the water and walk through in water. That's how they are able to walk on the water. Their beaks, their flat beaks help them to catch the fish and frog. They depend for food on fishes and frogs. And that's how they are able to survive in the water areas. Other ways of adapting. Okay, what are the other animals? How they are able to adapt and adjust to the surrounding. Birds. Birds which live in very cold countries, often they fly away to warmer parts of the earth during winters. Okay, and what they do? They lay eggs there. They look after the babies when they hatch. And when in summer, they return back to their native place. And this process is known as migration. So what is migration? Birds, what they fly? They fly from one country to other during the winter. And again, when it's summer, they come back to their own countries. Okay, and this process is called migration. Actually, migration is movement from one place to, means from one, shifting of one place to another. And again, they return back. For example, some birds like wagtails and greater flamingo, they visit India every winter. And these birds return back during summer to their native place. Monarch butterfly, it flies to Canada, from Canada to Mexico during the winter. Again, they return back to Canada during summers. Animals which cannot move away from their homes in winter, some cannot, they do not migrate. Instead, what they do? They hibernate. So what is hibernation? They sleep the entire winter months. Okay, since they cannot bear the cold, during entire winter, what they do? They go to sleep. Okay, they may curl up in warm places and go to sleep the entire winter. This is known as hibernation. They do not eat food during this time. Okay, and so what they do? They use up the fat stored in the body. That's how they survive. Bears, snakes, bats, toads, frogs, spiders. These are some insects and animals which hibernate. And it helps them to survive during extremely cold day. Now you should know the term, what is predator and prey. Predator, what are predator? Animals that hunt other animals are known as predators for their food, right? And animals that they hunt are known as prey. So predators, for their food, what they hunt? They hunt the prey. So that's the thing, that you should know the difference between predator and prey. The predators also need to hide so to catch their prey easily. For example, tree snakes look like one of the creepers on the tree. You cannot differentiate whether it's a creeper or a snake. So to catch the prey, they hide there. This keeps it safe from eagles or want to eat it. A chameleon, what it does? It sits on a branch in the garden, and you cannot know it's a chameleon or the branch. Because why? Why? Because it changes its color from gray to brown to reddish to green. Okay, actually what it does, it blends its color to the surrounding. What is the meaning of blend? It's look same to the surrounding, so you cannot differentiate them. And this process is known as what? Camouflage. What is camouflage? Animals that for their safety, they to catch their prey or to protect themselves, what they do? They blend their body color to the surrounding. They blend to the surrounding environment. That is known as camouflage. And camouflage helps the predator to catch their food. At the same time, it helps the prey to escape from their enemy. So for protection also, and to catch their prey also. That's how they use through camouflage. Okay, next we will see body covering of animals. How body covering of animals help the animals to adapt to their surrounding. A body is covered with skin, right? We all know it. Okay, our body is covered with what? It's covered with skin. Other animals also have body coverings. And what are the different body coverings we'll see of different animals? Like a bird's body, it's covered with what? It's covered with feathers. And what's the use of feathers? It's not only to keep the body warm, but it even helps them to fly. It helps the birds to fly. Reptiles. Reptiles such as snakes, crocodiles, and fish, how their body, what's the body covering? It's covered with scales. And body of amphibians, such as frogs and toads, is covered with what? The body covering is covered with loose, moist skin. The body of some animals like hedgehog and porcupines is covered with spines. So these are the different body coverings of different animals. Spines of porcupines are known as quills. Alright, what is known as? It's known as quills. Porcupines, what they do, they release their quills for self-defense. That is to protect themselves when they are being attacked, they release their quills. The body covering of mammals is covered with what? It's covered either with hair or with fur. And this helps them to control their body temperature, to keep them warm and to control their body temperature. Animals such as polar bear and yak, they live where? They live in the cold region. And what's the body covering? They have thick fur on their body, which keeps their body warm. Animals such as dog and cat, they live in warm region. Okay, so like when we have seen polar bear, where they live in cold region. Thus, they have thick fur, alright, to keep their body warm. But animals such as dog and cats, they live in warm region. They do not have those thick fur. They have thin fur on their body, alright. Or else it will be difficult for them to survive in such areas. Some animals like sheep, goat and rabbit, how is their body covering? Their body covering is with fine, soft, curly hair. Okay, that's their body covering. And we get what from them? We get wool from their soft, curly hairs. Animals like monkey, what they have? They have stiff, coarse hair called bristles. Okay, so what's the body covering of monkeys? Is bristles. Okay, their hairs, they are known as bristles because it is very stiff. Stiff is what? Like like it's very hard and in a standing position. Okay, that's the body covering. Stiff, you cannot move it. Actually, that is the meaning of stiff. The thickness of fur of some animals keep changing throughout the year. How it changes throughout the year? That means it grows more fur during the winters and shed off during the summers. That means more of the fur it grows during winters and it comes off, it comes out, they shed, okay, during the summer. The color and texture of the fur of different animals also vary. That means the color and the texture of all the animal furs of the animals are not same, it is different. All animals, no matter what their body structure is or where they live, they have to perform different life functions. Okay, wherever they are surviving, they need to perform different life functions. The functions are like breathing, feeding, movement. Okay, and for the function to run, they have different organs also, which perform this different functions. Okay, and the organs are like for breathing. Okay, the organs for breathing are in dogs are like lungs. And for fish, it's like gills. So these are the different functions which takes place in animals due to different organs. Alright, let's see how animals perform some of this function. Few organs which help them to survive or helps them in the functioning. Okay, first we will see breathing organs in animals. Animals, they breathe in what? They take in oxygen, and what they breathe out or they release? They release carbon dioxide. Now, oxygen, why it is important? It is essential. Why? Because to produce energy in the body of the animals, and it burns the food within the body and releases the energy for performing various activities. Okay, that's the use of oxygen. Okay, why? What's the use of oxygen? It produces energy. All right, for the animal. All right, for its survival, for its use. Animals, they get oxygen from where? They get the oxygen from the surrounding. And animals living on land, they breathe in oxygen present in the air. Okay, so land animals, the terrestrial animals, where they get oxygen from the air. Aquatic animals, they get the oxygen from they get oxygen which is dissolved in water. From the water they get the oxygen. And different animals use different organs, the breathing organs. Alright, such as lungs, skin, gills, spiracles, and even body surface or the body coverings. Alright, first we'll start with lungs. Okay, which are the animals which require lungs to breathe? Birds, reptiles, mammals, and even human beings. What are our breathing organs? It is lungs. Okay, and humans, where they have a pair of lungs in which area? In the chest region. Lungs, they are spongy air-filled bags, means baggy structure. Okay, that's the shape of the lung. And when we breathe in air through our nostrils, that is through the nose holes, right? The nostrils, the holes in your nose, through that we breathe in air. This air, where it reaches our lungs. Then in the lungs, the oxygen present in the air passes into the blood, and it is then carried throughout the body. After respiration, carbon dioxide collected from the body in the blood passes into the lung, and this is again breathed out by us. What actually it is? What's the functioning actually? When we breathe in air, where it goes? It goes into our lungs. Then the oxygen, it is passed into our blood. After that, through blood, it goes to different parts of the body. And then when a person respires, okay, or during the respiration, carbon dioxide is collected, okay, and it passes to the lungs, and then again it comes out through when a person breathes. This is how a person breathes in oxygen and releases carbon dioxide. Okay, that's in case of birds, reptiles, mammals. Now, about gills, how fish, crabs, oyster, tadpoles, alright, how they use gills to breathe. Okay, fish, crabs, oysters, tadpoles, and most other animals which live underwater, they breathe in oxygen dissolved in the water. They do not have lungs. Instead, what they have gills to breathe in air or the oxygen. Fish, they take in water through their mouth, and as the water passes through the gills, what they absorb, they absorb oxygen from the dissolved water, and this is absorbed into the blood. Then the carbon dioxide, which is produced after respiration, is also absorbed into the blood, and it's given out into the water through the gills. The same process which how humans respire and breathe out carbon dioxide, same process. Oxygen is taken in, okay, from the water, it reaches into the blood, and carbon dioxide is produced after respiration, and then it is again given out into the water through the gills. Next, skin. All right, frogs and toads are amphibians. What are amphibians? Those animals which live both on land and even in water. We already know that young tadpoles, how they breathe? They breathe through gills. They do not breathe through lungs. They are like fish-like structure, no? Right, tadpoles look like fish. However, as adults, they live both on land and in water. So they breathe in through different organs. Like on land, they breathe through lung. When they are on land, those frogs, toads, they breathe through lung. And when again they go under the water, they breathe through their moist skin. This is how frog uses gills, lungs, and moist skins to breathe in different parts. Earthworm and some other tiny organisms, they breathe in through their moist body surface. So from their body surfaces, they breathe in the air. Spiracles is another organ which insects, types of insects, use for breathing. Insects like cockroach, grasshoppers, they breathe through tiny holes which are present all over their body, and these tiny holes on their body are called spiracles. So what are spiracles? Those tiny holes which are present on their body. So they breathe in air through the spiracles. The spiracles lead to a network of air. Here I have roughly drawn a diagram. If you see it, the network of tubes, the tubes are interconnected, that is known as network. Network reaches to every part of the body, and air reaches the body tissues directly through this network. So through this tubes, network of tubes, the air reaches throughout the body. Body tissues absorb oxygen, and what they release, they also release carbon dioxide, which is expelled or which is released from the body through the same route. That means through spiracles only. They take in air through the spiracles, that is the oxygen, and they release carbon dioxide through the spiracles. So these are the different types of breathing organs in animals. So we are going to see feeding in animals. How, what type of food these different kinds of animals they eat for their survival. All living things need food to stay alive. Like we need food to stay alive, right? Similarly, animals also need food to stay alive. And what, why do we need food, or why do animals need food? Right, we are going to see those points. Because animals, they need food because it helps for their growth, and even it provides energy. Food provides the material needed for their growth. So from food, they get those materials which are needed for the growth, and even it provides energy. They get energy from the food to carry out different life processes. Different animals eat different types of food, and the body parts are adapted to different kinds of food they eat. Okay, there are different categories of animals based on the food they eat. First, we are going to see the type is herbivores. Okay, who are called herbivores? Animals those eat plants are called herbivores. Animals that eat plants or plant parts are called herbivores. So who are herbivores? Animals those eat plants are called herbivores. And such as cow, deer, goat, giraffe, zebra. Okay, these all are herbivores. Okay, these animals, they eat plants. How they eat or how they chew, right? We are going to see they chew through their incisors. Okay, they have sharp front teeth, those incisors for biting the food, and large back teeth, that is the molars for grinding the food. So what kind of teeth those herbivores have? They have incisors and molars for chewing and grinding the food, that is biting and grinding the food. Smaller herbivores like rats, rabbits, squirrels, okay, they gnaw, that is they keep biting it. Okay, so they keep biting the hard seeds or fruits, and these are known as rodents. So rats, rabbits, squirrels, they are called as the rodents. They, what type of teeth they have? They have long and sharp front teeth, those incisors. Okay, with the help of incisors they eat the food. Carnivores. Which category, what type of animals are called carnivores? Those eat other animals, they are known as carnivores. So who are carnivores? Those animals that eat the other animals. And examples are like tiger, lion, cat, dog. Okay, these are the examples of carnivores. They have sharp pointed and curved canines for tearing the flesh. The teeth which they have is canines to tear the flesh, and they have strong grinding teeth for chewing the flesh and bones. Okay, this is how they chew and tear the flesh and chew it. Flesh eating birds such as eagle, vulture, kite, these are known as birds of prey because they eat the flesh of other animals or birds. Okay, they have sharp hooked beaks for tearing the flesh of their victims, means on what they are going to feed on. Okay, this type of birds of prey, on what they are going to feed on, they with the help of their beaks they tear the flesh. And they also have sharp and strong claws. Their claws are known as talons. Okay, with the help of talons they catch their prey on which they are going to feed. The next category based on the food habit is omnivores. What are omnivores? Omnivores are those animals which depend both on plants and animals. Human beings and bears is an example. Even human beings are omnivores because we depend for our food on plants as well as animals. And what are the types of teeth they have? Incisors, canines, as well as molars also for chewing and biting the food. And these help them to eat hard as well as even soft food. That's how their teeth help them to eat the food. Movement in animals. So now animals, they have different organs even for their movement purpose, that is to go from one place to another. Unlike plants, animals like insects, birds and human beings can move on their own. Okay, so moving, the movement, those organs which help them in their movement. Okay, they have different types of organs which help in movement, and this movement is known as locomotion. Now locomotion helps for what? On the movement, why plants, animals move, for what purpose they move? That is to find food and protect themselves. Okay, they look for shelter, place for breeding. Breeding is means to give birth. Okay, so for these are the different purposes that animals move. So we are going to see the different categories of animals. First, we will start with our terrestrial animals. Okay, most animals on land, they move with what? They move with the help of their legs. So that is even known as limbs. Now animals, they have four limbs. It is called as forelimb and hind limb. Okay, you call it as forelimb and hind limb. Forelimbs are the front two limbs and hind limbs are the back two limbs. Okay, animals such as tiger, dogs, cats move with the help of their four legs, that is both their forelimbs and hind limbs. But kangaroo, human beings, okay, we move only on two limbs, that is our hind limbs, our legs. And these animals, they have strong legs and we can move fast, okay, with the help of their two legs only. Human beings are the most developed among all animals. Why are we most developed? Let's see the reason. Because we can walk on two hind limbs, that is on leg, and we can use our four limbs, that is our hands, for different purposes like catching, holding, and doing various activities like doing different types of works. We use our hand and we use our legs to walk. That's why we are the most developed among all the animals. They use only one pair of limbs, that is legs, to support their body. So we use our legs to support our body. That's why we are erect in our posture and we use our legs to stand, walk and run. That's how our legs are helpful. Next, we will see the next category of animals, that is reptiles. Reptiles are like lizards, tortoise and crocodiles. Okay, how they move? They crawl on the land with the help of their short legs. These type of reptiles, they move on the land with the help of their short legs. But snakes, they do not have legs. So how do they move? They move with by curving its body and pushing against the ground with the help of what? With the help of scale that is present on the underside of the body. That's how they move. And it has very strong muscular system, and the backbone, their backbone is flexible, so it helps in the movement. This in the case of reptiles. Now in the case of insects, how many pairs of legs they have? They have three pairs of legs, and they can move in different types of ways, such as walking, crawling, hopping. So they can move in different types of ways. Ant and cockroach, they use their legs for what purpose? They use their legs for walking. Beetles, lice, bed bugs, okay, they use their legs for what purpose? They use their legs for crawling. Okay, but grasshoppers, what they use their legs for? They use their long and powerful hind legs, okay, that is to hop on the ground. They use for hopping on the ground. The water boatman, it uses what? It uses his hands, leg as oars, that is to push the water. When you go riding on a boat, what do? You use the oars to push the water, right? Similarly, water boatman also, it uses his hind leg as oars to move in water. Butterflies, bees, housefly, what they have? They have wings that helps them to fly. Butterflies and bees and asps, even dragonflies, how many wings they have? They have four wings. But housefly, how many wings it has? It has only two wings. You should know the differences. It will come surely in your one word. Okay, next, aquatic animals. What are aquatic animals? Those animals that live in the water, they are aquatic animals. Now, how do they move? Okay, we will see. Fishes, they have what? They have fins for swimming. Okay, that's how they move in the water. And the fins, it helps them to move forward and even maintain their balance, their body balance. Tail fin, it helps them to even change the direction of the movement. In the way they move, it helps to change the direction in the movement. Turtles and tortoise, what they have? They have legs which are shaped like paddles. Okay, and they use their legs to push the water back and move forward. So they push it, push the water backwards and they move forward. That's how they use their legs, that is paddles. Penguins, what they have? They use their two forelimbs as flippers to push the water and move forward. Okay, so penguins, what they have? They have their forelimbs, that is flippers. Okay, in case of turtles, they have paddles. In case of penguins, they have flippers. Frogs, what they have? They have a web feet which help them to push the water and move forward. And on land, how do they move? They move by jumping and hopping with the help of their long hind legs, that is their back legs. This is how aquatic animals move. Next we will see birds. Okay, birds, how they move? Four limbs of birds, they are modified into what? They are modified into the wings for flying purpose. That's how they fly in the air, because their four limbs are modified into wings. Birds, they move in the air by flapping their wings, like moving up and down, no, the wing, that is known as flapping their wings. Okay, with their wings, which are covered with feathers. The wings are covered with feather. They have light body, that is light in weight. Okay, their body is light in weight. That's why they are able to fly easily in the air. And they use their two legs to perch on branches, like stand or rest or sit on the branches. They use their two legs to rest on the branches. They also use them to walk or hop on the ground. They use their legs even to walk or hop on the ground. And some birds, such as emu, ostrich, kiwi, what they have? They have very weak wings. Okay, and their body is heavy. That's why they cannot fly. Okay, all birds cannot fly, such like emu, ostrich, kiwi. Okay, why they cannot fly? Because their wings are weak and their body weight is heavy. Some birds, like duck, swan, what type of feet they have? They also have the web feet for swimming purposes. Okay, so ducks and swan, what type of feet they have? They have the web feet which help them to move in the water. So we have seen how different animals can move using their different types of body organs. Okay, I want you all to go through once again, go through the lesson once again, so that it will be clear for you all. Thank you.